Anyway, when I found out a few months back that the Seldom scene was going to be here, I got all excited. And then I got to see him with John Starling, who is back with the Seldom scene now full time. Yes, ma'am. Ooh, oh. It's the pants, John. Anyway, a lady was just commenting on how she came at 1 and she came back at 5 just to see John and his pants. But you know, it was an event there in Wilkesboro a few weeks back, and John Starling is back with them full time. But then I found out that John can't be with them at every performance. And I said, well, that's too bad. But then Lance went on to say, but Tony Rice is going to be filling in. Yeah. So there's nothing wrong with that, is it? Give him a big hand. Once again, the Seldom scene. Special guest, Tony Rice.
Speaker's green. It's called "I'd Give an Ocean of Diamonds and a World Full of Flowers."
Can you dance?
I don't know. Can you?
I've never seen you.
Just don't stir up any dust.
Give an ocean
Tell you what's trying to land here, it's the mid-range. I had somebody tell me that. Oops. I was in tune last week. Never more than a fret away. It's called The Long Black Veil.
Nobody knows. The scaffold was high, and eternity near. She stood in the crowd, Lord, she shed not a tear. And sometimes at night, when the cold
As soon as they get all the property acquired and everything down here, I want to see this place air-conditioned. Okay, well, it's nothing a little right guard won't cure. We've slipped up to the people's key of B, right? Fledermaus. Thank you. take the bass out of the monitors here is what T requests. Was that a yes? Was that a no?
It's not in there.
Oh, it's not in there.
It's in the side fills, I think.
We just... Something keeps trying to land up here, that's why. Okay. It's a C note?
It's a C note, if that helps you. It's hard to stay away from C notes in bluegrass.
And if you don't prefer to talk in major keys, we can call it a B sharp. All right. What you up to? Oh, Tony? Are you going to render? It's his choice.
For what? For Tony to do what? Just sensitive. It's all yours. We have to kind of think a little bit. Tony was just working with his own group, the unit, last night, and he has to run down and try and think of things to do with us. And so sometimes it takes us a little longer than usual because we normally are called Alzheimer and the All Braille Band anyway. But this really stretches it. You know? You say you have a problem there? Oh, he can do all those he wants. You have to catch him in the right frame of mind. Approach him on your knees, you know. Okay, have we made a decision, or shall I render dark eyes?
Ah, we tried.
Here's another one. It's here and here and there.
Oh, yeah. It's a faster.
It's what Tony does marvelously well.
You don't know my mind, silly thing.
Legendship has agreed to step forward to the vocal mic and render a few words and versions of whatever it is he chooses.
Very few words. I would like to tell you a real quick little story about this song that was written back in the 1920s by my uncle, a man named Ellsworth Cousins, who was the first Dobro player that played on the first Jimmy Rogers recordings in 1928, and he wrote this song that Jimmy Rogers recorded and had a pretty big hit and made lots of money. Jimmy Rogers did, not my uncle. He kind of died a poor man, but I always thought it was a beautiful song. Always wanted to record it. It's called Treasures Untold.
your eyes so blue, I've loved you forever, it seems. I've longed for you, dear, and wanted you near, for you are the girl of my dreams. And though I have met you just now, I'll tell you my dream somehow. If I could but win your heart, little girl, then I would have treasures untold. The kisses that we've shared in my sweetest dreams are even more precious than gold. How I love your sweet face and your dear smiling eyes. So often the story's been told. If I could but win your heart, little girl, then I would have treasures untold.
Version, the takeoff on The World Is Waiting for the Sunrise. But these guys, all they can do is play the melody. So,
no, they're just not creative.
But that's all right. Tony knows how to. Tony knows how to play that jazz.
I don't know about that.
Sure you do.
Give me a famous DJ.
Thank you.
Okay, well, that was just average. Well, it went a few and lose a few. Huh? I don't think we can do that. Tony doesn't know that. Probably not. I haven't put out a feeler for requests yet. We have to let Tony decide. So meanwhile, we can discuss things. Right. It's a real pretty song that we've always liked, and nobody else does, so we're going to play it anyway. For our own amusement. It's called Another Lonesome Morning. Disgusting to sober today. It's awful to work this way. I don't know how people do it. So I guess we'll leave you with this one, another golden classic. And this was on our 15th anniversary, I believe. I don't know how to make the opening remarks. No, I don't. I love to hear it on banjo. It just makes me tingle.
Years roll by. And to me there'll never be another. I'll live out till the day I die.
Pleasure, and we certainly thank Tony for helping us out. As I said earlier, and some of you might not have heard, if this was a classroom, you'd say, "Boy, it's a hell of a substitute teacher. Can't find any better." So here he's going to render for you. Story of John Hardy.
Thank you. getting away. I ought to see John Hardy getting away. Let him run up to Virginia on the East Old Bridge. Thought he would surely be free. Then along came a marshal with a gun in his hand. Said, Johnny, come along with me. Johnny, come along with me.
Gentlemen, the Seldom scene. Ben Eldridge on the banjo. T. Michael Coleman on the bass. Mike Auldridge on that Dobro. John Duffey on that mandolin. Mr. Tony Rice on the guitar. The Seldom scene.